Hello everybody and welcome to this tutorial. Today I will show you another brute forcing method, primarily because the one that I've showed you previously does require you to gather some information prior to the attack itself, primarily because you cannot perform a brute force attack for every possible combination out there for the VPA to passkey. Why? Well, simply because you have too many of them to try and you don't have enough processing power. The best you could do is combine, let's say, the best a home user could do is combine pretty much all of the devices that they have in the house. For example, your smartphone, a tablet, a laptop, a computer, and you could combine the processing power of those of all of those devices and basically distribute the decryption cracking onto all of those devices. However, even then you would still find it very difficult and you would still have way too many combinations to deal with. Again, you have online services which you can rent service to do this, but that costs money and yeah, it's not easy to come by these days. Anyway, do not despair, there's no reason to panic or anything of a kind. I know that the previous method is somewhat difficult and it does require you to actually go out there and gather some information on your own. However, this method that I am about to show you doesn't require you to gather much information at all. Basically, what somebody has come up with is this extremely stupid idea of PIN authentication for wireless networks. And there is a major flaw in it. First of all, PIN authentication only has numbers, which dramatically reduces the amount of combinations possible. Namely, there are only 11,000 combinations. And considering that the Reverb splits the length of the PIN code in two, once it finds the first half, finding the second half gets a lot easier, so you don't even need to do, in all likelihood, you won't actually need to do all 11,000 combinations at all. Now, if you have watched the previous tutorial, you have seen that I can do maybe 1,700 up to perhaps 2K passwords a second, or 2K attempts per a second. You would think that, oh well, 11,000 possibilities, not much at all, probably less than 10 seconds, it would be over. However, that is not the case, because the sort of attack that we're going to perform now does not, we're not going to be doing it locally, we're not going to be doing it on the machine itself. It's not like we will have a file that we will be able to use our processor to crack the encryption of that file. Rather, instead, we will be doing this remotely. So we will come into the range of a wireless access point and then we will attempt to attack that wireless access point by trying to pass PIN codes. And if any of them works out, we're gonna get a response from the Reverb software and it will basically tell us what is the passcode, what is the VPA2 pre-shared key for that particular access point. The downside of it all is that most of the routers these days, even though the brilliant router manufacturers have actually decided to put PIN authentication to be enabled by default on most of the routers out there, they did fortunately put a preventive measure, which is the router itself basically locks after you've passed the incorrect PIN several times. It will lock and it will not allow any PIN authentication of whatsoever to go on for a certain period of time, usually maybe an hour or something of a kind. You can immediately deduce from this that this leaves possibilities for numerous DOS attacks, and all you would have to do is authenticate falsely a couple of times and PIN authentication would be disabled for pretty much anybody there. And there are a good amount of networks out there who rely primarily and only on PIN authentication. Why, I have no idea. So, without further ado, I have showed in the previous tutorials, if you don't have Reverb installed, how to install it. But in this particular one, I'm gonna just go ahead and use it. I won't do any of the installation procedures because they're already done in the previous tutorials. So just go ahead and type in Reverb --help And you will get a ton load of options. I mean, well, maybe not a ton load, but certainly a good amount of options. We will be using some of them. More likely than not, when dealing with different kinds of routers, you will be required to use some of these options, use some of these arguments primarily because, different routers have different configurations, and you want to be able to hide your attacks or to mask yourself somehow. Not because you're gonna get detected or something like that, because it's not likely that anybody can actually track you down if you are attacking a wireless access point, as if provided, of course, that you are not authenticated with it. If you are not authenticated with a wireless access point, and if you're just attacking it like this via wireless radio or something of a kind, basically there's almost no way to detect you. There is no way to find your physical location or to identify you. Sure, your MAC address will probably show somewhere, but what do you care? All you need to do, as I stated in the previous tutorial, is type MAC changer and change it. No problems. If you don't know how to change the MAC address, just go back a tutorial two or two, and you will find a section called not a section. You will find a tutorial called MAC or MAC changing or something of a kind, but it will have a word MAC in it, MAC. And there I have explained in great detail how you can actually hide your MAC address without any sort of problems of whatsoever. The primary things that we're going to be using today, the primary arguments, that is I interface, and we will of course need the BSS ID or MAC of the target access point. Before we do that, as before with aircrack-ng, we do need to do a couple of things. We need to set the mode of our network card. So I'm not going to go into great detail how to do it here because I have explained it in the previous tutorials. Here I'm just going to do it, and hopefully you will be able to follow through. If not, just go back a tutorial or two and see. I have given detailed explanations there. So just type in ifconfig, oops, some fig, type in the name of your wireless access card and bring it down. Oops, operation not permitted. I'm not root, of course. Okay, I always loved my passwords primarily because of their length. I sometimes tend to forget them, which is infinitely interesting. But there you go, I've managed to type it in. And it's actually a good thing that I haven't managed to log in just yet as root, because I have my router opened here, which I've set up for the testing purposes of this particular tutorial. And you can see the current pin. I mean, these pins are generated at random. So you can see the length of the pin, and you can see the pin here. I can say generate new pin. Let's see what happens. The change of wireless config will not take. Yeah, okay. So it will not take effect until the device reboots. But here you can see the length of the pin. So it's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Only 8 digits. And if I do it again, it's going to be 8 again. So 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Oops, sorry, not 8. It's going to be 9. Is it 9? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Sorry, no, it's going to be 8 again. It's always going to be 8, so no problems there. You know the length of the pin, which dramatically decreases the amount of possible combinations as well. Depending on what sort of a router you have, the pin can be at different places in the router. I can't explain it for every individual router, but you can find it in the manual or something like that. Just open up a web interface for your router by typing in the IP address. If you want to know what the IP address of your router is on a Linux system, that is very easy to do. You can just type in route, press enter, and this might take a bit of time. I'm not exactly sure why is it taking so long, primarily because I'm not connected to the network. Okay, so ifconfig is another way. But here it would say gateway, and where it says gateway, that would be the default address of your router. However, that is the default gateway. That does not necessarily need to be the IP address of the router you are connected to. So type in ifconfig. This is a foolproof way of getting the IP address of the router, much better than the previous one. And I want to get the IP address of the router to which my wireless access point is associated with. So VLP2S0, press enter, and there we go. I have an IP address here. Okay, let's just clear this up a bit. clear. I want to get a bit of a better picture. Grep inet. Excellent. So I have inet here, and this is the internet address, but this is my local address. It's not to be used for external purposes at all. It's 192.168.0.102, and the difference between your wired and wireless connection is usually this digit here. For wired, it's 1, and for wireless, it's 0, and then you have a list of hosts which are here. Anyway, my IP address in my local area network that my wireless interface has is 192.168.0.102. The lowest possible IP address within this range, with only the last octet changing, is .0. So from 0 to 255, and the lowest one would be 0. But you cannot use 0 because that is the network address. So what you do is find the lowest one here, which is 0, plus 1, and that's going to give you the IP address of your router. Very simple. And you can see that is exactly what I've typed in here. It's 192.168.0.1. So just find the lowest one, which is 0, of course, and then add 1, which is going to be the IP address of the router. Anyway, now that that is out of the way, I've showed you how you can check it out here, the PIN code, but this interface will differ from one router to another. Please keep that in mind. So this is not a general explanation for all the routers out there, but it's fairly simple to find the PIN code on your own home router without any bigger difficulties. Just go ahead and log into it via web interface, as I said. Just type in the address here. You will be prompted for login credentials. Usually it's admin if you haven't changed anything. If it's not, go ahead and contact your ISP provider and ask them to provide the username and password for you, assuming that it's not locked. If it's locked, you gotta break it, but I will show you how you can break routers in the tutorials to come. In any case, let's just go back to the subject here. Now I am root. Let's take down my wireless interface. I have fig vlp2s0 down. And now I need IV config VLP2S0 mode monitor. Excellent. So IF config VLP2S0 up. There we go. You can make a neat short script, the bash script, which has these commands listed, and that could be a fantastic way to do this. You would effectively save yourselves a lot of time there. Go ahead and clear the screen, and there is a you see it says connection to something, it has been deactivated because my wireless interface has now been brought down and up, and it's in and on top of that it's in monitor mode. Now, there is a program which I've used in the previous tutorial, which is a part of the Aircrack package. It's called airmon-ng, and I want to check VLP2S0 for any possible problems. I have explained this in the previous tutorial. Why am I doing this and how is this done? So airmon-ng check VLP2S0. Of course, your wireless interface name will probably not be the same if you're not using the same OS as I am, but just substitute it with whatever it is, and no problems there. In the previous tutorials, I've also stated that. Here we have a list of problems, as I like to call them. These are the list. The primary problem is the network manager, because it's generating a lot of the other things up here. So let's just go ahead and kill them. 13133. I gotta kill them one by one because they are spawning one another, and that can be problematic. So kill 2498. 2498, even if you are root, they can give you a ton load of problems, primarily because, as I said, they are spawning one another, and that can be just such an unbelievable drag. Excellent. Now I have, let me just clear the screen again. Now I have ran the check once again to make sure that I don't have any problems. If you're afraid that you will kill something that you don't want to kill in terms of networking, don't worry, anything from that list will auto-generate pretty much the moment you reinitiate your network manager. You can just type in service network manager restart, and all those processes will be generated. If you don't want to do this, you can just reboot the machine and you will have pretty much the same effect, no problems. So just go ahead and clear the screen. Before I actually start using Reverb, which we have installed previously, I do need to check for wireless connections within my area, and I do need to check whether they are vulnerable. Very important thing to do. And that I will do in the follow-up tutorial. We will use the wash command in order to find these interfaces, in order to find these at wireless access points. Until then, I bid you farewell, and I hope to see you there.